One of the joys of being in show business is to travel around over the country and make new friends. Oh, I make friends all over the world, and I have a dear friend out at Bernie, Texas, named Joe Pollock. Joe's the sheriff out there. I've done a lot of shows in that area. He comes to them. His sheriff's association has sponsored me on occasion. Well, the other day, my buddy from Texas called me and said, "Jerry, I want to come to your place over in Mississippi and go quail hunting." I said, "Well, man, you're going to have to hurry because the season's about to run out. And I'm fixed to go off on a 10-day tour. But you fly to Baton Rouge, Louisiana. I'll get Marcel Ledbetter to meet you. And Marcel will be your host. And he'll take you bird hunting." Well, my friend from Texas flew to Baton Rouge. Marcel met him. They drove up to southwest Mississippi and went quail hunting on Jerry Clower's farm. They was having a good time. They'd been out there for about an hour and a cottontail cornfield rabbit jumped up. Man from Texas said, "Marcel, what in the world is that?" Marcel said, "That's a rabbit." "A rabbit? Ha! Out in Texas, our rabbit's as big as that calf right young." Well, they went on hunting, and a little bit of coon dog come running by, a tree and walker. Man from Texas said, "Marcel, what in the world's that?" Said, "That's a coon dog, a tree and walker." "Ha! A dog? While out in Texas, our dog's as big as that cow, right, y'all?" Well, come time to eat dinner, Marcel decided he'd ride my friend into Macomb, Mississippi, and take him to the dinner bell. Got a big lazy Susan table, and you can pitch till you win. They're riding down the highway headed into Macomb and is going across Tangipahoa River. A great big old turtle, loggerhead turtle, big as a dishpan, was coming across the highway. And just as they got up to him, he went down the bank toward the river. Man from Texas said, "Marcel, what in the world is that?" Marcel said, "That's a tick." Bunk Ledbetter got him a job as a guard. Late one evening, they had a jailbreak. A couple of them got out of Angola and had to swim a swift river to get off of the Angola grounds proper. Well, Bunk and his department was right there on the edge of the river, and up drove a great, big old powerful truck with the generators on it, and they turned on a big spotlight that would reach all the way across the river, and you could see a gnat on a tree over there. Huge, powerful spotlight. And the warden told Bunk, said, "Bunk, we need to cross the river. We ain't gonna be able to wait for no boat. The prisoner will be done gone." And said, "Bunk, that light is so powerful, it's so thick, you can actually walk on it." Be just like walking across the river on a log. "Get up there, Bunk, and go on across and chase that criminal what broke out of the penitentiary." Bunk said, "I don't believe I want to do it." Man said, "Bunk, don't you believe me that the light will hold you up?" Bunk said, "Sure, I believe you, but I'm afraid I'll get about halfway across the river and you'll cut the light off." We got a little problem in southwest Mississippi. One of our dearest pastors went to the hospital the other day, looked down into the face of one of his deacons, and tubes was coming out of the deacon's nose. And he knelt down by his bed and took his man by the hand and said, "Brother, I want to pray for you, and I hope you get all right. The man took his hand out of the preacher's hand, and he was trying to speak, and he was having difficulty to speak, and he pointed to a pen and a pad on the nightstand, and the preacher handed it to him, and he wrote quickly, and just as he finished writing, the pen fell out of his hand, and the dear brother died. The pastor was buried him 2 days later, and he was up eulogizing him and saying wonderful things about him. And he said, oh, I just happened to remember his last words. He wrote them down and handed them to me. They're in my coat pocket. I want to share them with you and tell you what this man of God said as he was dying. He said, Pastor, you're kneeling on my oxygen hose back up.